Hey everybody, as many of you all know that Amber Geiger has been sentenced to 10 years in prison. And of course, if that wasn't a slap in our face enough, the brother Botham of Botham Shim Jean, Brandt Jean, he decided to do something that many of us are quite baffled with. And honestly, I didn't really know how to approach this situation. That's why I kind of, you know, reserved my thoughts before speaking on it. I prayed about it this morning, and I listened to, you know, different people that I respect within the Hebrew community and their opinions. I listened to different black commentators, whether they were analysts or, you know, just people giving their random opinion about it. And there was almost an agreed upon sentiment from everybody that what this brother displayed was, it was coonery and buffoonery. But particularly in the Hebrew community, one of the things that was brought up was, you know, the fact that this man is a Christian. And this is what the Christian faith teaches, that we are supposed to turn the other cheek and forgive, forgive, forgive. And unfortunately, that whole idea behind us forgiving has become very perverted. I believe that we are to love our enemies and pray for those who despitefully use us. I believe that we are to forgive people for the sins that they do against us. Because if we don't forgive, then Father Yah will not forgive us for our sins. I believe in all of that. But if you got an opportunity to see what this young man did and the way he handled the situation with begging to hug Amber Geiger, getting up, and the hug lasted probably about more than a minute long, the display in which he showed himself before the world, it seemed to me less of a Christian approach and more of the mental shackles that we have been put under. Now, this is not to throw shade at this man, because none of us are in his shoes. None of us understands what it is to lose a family member in the way in which he lost his family member, especially one of such high integrity as his brother. And this is a family of much integrity, so I do not want to diminish the integrity of this family, nor do I want to be on the other side, because as a fellow Christian myself, I do not believe that it is Christianity that promotes what we saw on display, but rather a perversion due to white supremacy. And if you have not gotten a chance to see Dana Stevens, who is on the One Love channel, and he talks about how America's God is the God of white supremacy wrapped in a cloak of Christianity. If you haven't gotten a chance to see that, I'm going to try to leave that in the description link below so you can check it out. This is a Gentile brother, and he breaks it down very well. And he's gotten quite a few white people upset by what he said, but it is true. Unfortunately, I believe that, you know, the perversion of Christianity with all of its historical factors deeply rooted in white supremacist mindsets is what we saw on display. It's a slave mentality. But today, what I came across while I was on Facebook was the opinion of this woman who I'm going to share it with you, because I just really felt like the way she expressed herself was so well put that it really wrapped up a lot of the sentiments in which I feel. So I'm going to read it to you. I hope the sun isn't too much in my face as I'm going to do so. This woman, her name is Karen Zacharias, and this is what she says. In the Amber Geiger sentencing today, the brother of Botham John, the black man shot dead while eating a bowl of ice cream in his own apartment, told the white police officer that he didn't want her to go to prison. Brandt Jean told Amber that he forgave her. He told her he loved her. He told her that she needed to turn to God and see Jesus Christ. The judge wept, and now Brandt is being heralded as a model of grace and forgiveness. You would think as a woman of faith, I would love this example of the power of forgiveness and grace. And yes, whenever there is grace, there is a tenderness and humanity that is worth marveling over. But as a white woman who grew up in Georgia during the time of the Selma March, the battle over busing, and was forbidden from associating with any blacks except those employed by whites, I loathe this narrative. It shames me, this narrative. Such grace is too often presumed by whites. The expectation is that whites will be forgiven no matter how egregiously we wrong blacks. Blacks are applauded for being so merciful, while whites are continually exonerated for being so murderous. It's the modern day twist on the slave narrative. No matter how many beatings a black receives, he or she is expected to forgive and to exemplify an uncommon loyalty. They are expected to be the example of Christ to the world. That's not to take away from grace that Brandt Jean displayed. It's just wrong, I think, to applaud those moments when we once again perpetuate the narrative that puts the onus of forgiveness on blacks for all the horrible wrongs whites do to them. Some of the very same people praising Brandt Jean for forgiving Amber Geiger would lock their car doors in his presence or walk on the other side of the street and would not want their white daughters dating him or their white sons being college roommates with him. We need to stop the myth-making that compels blacks to subjugate themselves before whites, because the truth is such myths teaches us that Amber's life is more valuable than Botham Jean's life. Despite the evidence to the contrary, Amber was not a good person. Botham Jean was. I felt like she just encapsulated so much the heart behind was somebody who's being honest, somebody who's being somebody who is not looking at this country through the lens of white supremacy. That this woman is saying, this is the reality that black people go through in this country all the time, and that we want them to mentally subjugate themselves before us and say, do you forgive? Do you forgive? Every single time something happens between a black person, even whether it's a child or a woman or a man, the media thrust a camera in their face, thrust a microphone in their face and says, do you forgive this person who did that to you? I have very rarely, as a matter of fact, I don't think I've ever seen that same line of questioning happen when it's a white person that is has been victimized or accused someone of being a victim of someone who is black of a heinous crime that has been committed against them. And this is the mental shackles that I'm talking about. So originally I thought, as a believer, you know, we should forgive. We should definitely listen to the Ruach. We definitely need to be able to do that. And we need to allow this man to be able to have his moment that he felt that he needed. We don't need to be beating this brother down. And I still feel that we don't need to beat him down. He needs time to heal. But as a community, it's very important that we understand that there is a fine line. There is definitely a fine line when it comes to the word of the Most High Yah, because he is a God of grace, but he's also a God of justice. And what happened with Amber Geiger was, what she did was unjust, but also the sentencing that happened afterwards. She was supposed to receive a minimum of 20 to 25 years for the crime in which she was held guilty of. But she was given half of that time and will also be eligible up for parole within 5 years. As a community, we see people with nonviolent crimes. I just read an article about this yesterday. Nonviolent crimes who receive up to 99 years for nonviolent crimes, usually dealing with drugs. So when we see these types of situations like this, or Felicity Hoffman, where they're getting a slap on the wrist, they're getting 2 weeks in prison, or they're getting no time, or even the late the gentleman who committed suicide, that he was released from jail 6 days out of the week so that he could work and only had to report to jail once. But this was a pedophile, and he was able to get off. And now Jeff Epstein is the gentleman I'm talking about who committed suicide. But my point is that this is an imbalanced system. And an abomination before the Most High Yah is unjust weights and balances. I do not believe that anybody needs to hate anyone, whether they are Hebrew or Gentile. I don't believe in hatred. I believe that hatred actually is a poison to us. It's like unforgiveness is drinking poison, waiting for the other person to die. So I'm not against anybody forgiving. I'm not against this brother forgiving. What I am against is the imagery and the display that has been shown before white America and black America, that we continuously are being looked at as though we are supposed to be the merciful ones and the forgiving ones, but there is no recourse. There is no standard for repentance. This is something that has been on my heart for a very long time, because even when I was involved heavily with the pro-life movement, I noticed that when it came to the white actors, the evangelicals in particular, who were standing for life, they were not dealing with the reality that systemically white people have been responsible for creating a pro-choice movement or a pro-abortive movement within the black community via the Negro Project, through Margaret Sanger. A lot of times they don't want to deal with the race factor, and that they cause the problem and then try to manage the solution at the same time. So I think that it's very unfortunate that we saw this display, this open display of this brother who put a lot of us in a situation whereby our feelings, how we are handling and processing Amber Geiger being sentenced only to 10 years, is now being on open display by white America. Like, okay, he forgave, so why can't you guys forgive? He forgave and hugged, so why can't you guys do that? But we're not dealing with a criminal injustice system and the fact that cops and white people in general are not held to the same standard that black people are held to when going to court. So I think that is the larger issue that many of us are dealing with, is that there is injustice, and the injustice is being swept under the rug to promote this pseudo-false forgiveness that we are supposed to have. Not to say that this brother didn't forgive, but this idea that anything and everything can happen to us as a people, and our automatic response before we even process through the emotions of what happened is, oh, well, he forgive, so isn't that the standard by which all of you should live? Well, where's the standard that you should live? Where's the standard that your people should live when dealing with our people? Hold yourselves accountable instead of trying to hold us as a people accountable. So in any case, that's my opinion about this whole situation. But again, no, I don't believe that we need to be giving this brother backlash. We don't need to. We're not in his shoes. We don't know the pain that he's feeling. But understand that I believe that we as a people need to reconcile with this issue of race and be free to do so without white partiality, without white narrative to speak to how we should handle and process our emotions through this whole situation, how we should handle and process the system and dealing with the inequities in the system through this situation. So that's my thoughts about it. I definitely want to hear yours. Please drop a comment below and let me know what you think about this whole situation between Botham Shim's brother and Amber Geiger, as well as the judge who also hugged Amber Geiger, which is unprecedented because judges should not, in a professional manner, get off the bench to do that, to hug a criminal in that manner. We have to ask ourselves if that's something that would be expected of a white judge with a black criminal. It would not be expected at all, but the expectation is that she did it, and so this is such an open display of love. Actually, what she did furthered this problem that we have within the black community with a slave mentality. So that's my opinion about the whole situation. Like I said, I definitely want to hear yours below. Like and share, as well as if you haven't gotten a chance to subscribe to Ashonda at Large, definitely please do so. And as always, and my message doesn't change because I don't agree with how this brother handled his display of forgiveness. Love yourself without hating your enemies. And until next time, Yah bless and Salamah.